I think that when you look at the gospel, you have to look at Jesus. How big was Jesus? He was bigger than Levitical law. He was bigger than the Gentiles. He was bigger than the Pharisees. He was bigger than the Jews. He fills heaven and earth, Colossians tell us. That's how big he is. And that's hard for us to wrap our head around because we limit Jesus to a picture or a figurine on a cross or a statue, or you know, we limit him to time when he is completely eternal and above and beyond it. So I think in our own heart, in our own life, we have to realize that there are things that Jesus would do that we would never do. There are people he would touch that in our fear and insecurity, we would not touch. And the Apostle Paul said to the church, I think it was at Colossae, he said, you know, I'm really afraid of you because your whole life is centered around touch not, taste not, you know, handle not. And Paul said, you know, that frightens me because God is not like that. God will touch you. God will be involved in the things. In fact, there's one famous preacher, he says, if it matters to you, it matters to God. And that's a very profound statement because we always think, I want to do what matters to God. But God's like, no, what matters to you? What do you care about? What do you care about? If you care about it, I care about it because I'm God. I'm big enough to care about everything. And you know, we don't have difficulty thinking that God cares about the broken or the, you know, the abandoned or the orphan or situations like that. Well, we don't realize that God just is not the God of the broken. He's the God of the blessed. He cares about all of our life, every aspect of our life. You know, how big is your gospel? Well, it's bigger than the world. It's bigger than any enemy we face. It's bigger than any realm of darkness. This gospel is the most amazing, amazing message, but you would never know it from the church because we limit that message to our comfort level instead of going out. You know, Jesus was a friend of sinners. We just don't know how to deal with that. We don't, because we're supposed to separate from sinners. And yet Jesus did not do that. He did not, I'm not saying he sinned, but he did not separate. Why? Because he wasn't afraid of sinning, because he had pure love.